Happy Saturday morning and welcome back to my channel. And did you know that 2021 is the 18th anniversary of Starbucks releasing their pumpkin spice latte and completely changing the beverage game as we know it? Well, since then, every fall they roll out with a new festive menu designed to tickle and tantalize your taste buds. Well, Tim Hortons is Canada's biggest coffee chain, and they just weren't gonna let somebody else steal their thunder. So they went ahead and counterpunched with a fall menu of their own at a lower price. Is the higher priced Starbucks the better quality, or has Tim Hortons found the recipe to the consumer's heart? Well, today we're gonna settle that once and for all with a restaurant showdown taste test. Here's how this works. Every single round, we're gonna pair similar items from each restaurant. The one that tastes better scores the point and wins the round. The restaurant with the most points after 5 rounds is declared the winner and will be crowned this year's Pump King. We're gonna kick off our battle today with the drink that started it all, the Pumpkin Spice Latte. On the left, I've got the original Pumpkin Spice Latte from Starbucks, the tall retailing for $4.95. And on the right, I've got a small Pumpkin Spice Latte from Tim Hortons, retailing for just $3.25. Right away, you'll notice there's a considerable difference in price, which gives a little advantage to Tim Hortons as far as I'm concerned. Not a great start, Starbucks. You're already playing from behind heading into the taste test. Man, that's a special drink. I know some of you sitting at home get your pumpkin spice panties in a twist because of the over-pumpkinization of our culture in the fall, but if you want something to blame, it's this right here. This drink is a near-perfect creation. It's like ordering a coffee and being given a perfect piece of pumpkin pie. Tim's, I don't know what you think a pumpkin spice latte is, but this isn't it. Tim's, if I'm being honest, I'm legitimately concerned about you and thinking about getting on the phone and calling a social worker because I'm not 100% sure you know how to take care of yourself anymore. I mean, for God's sakes, you're a donut shop. You made your name using sugar. Why does this taste like the burnt residue from the bottom of your coffee pots? It's bitter. It's nasty. Forget the $1.70 savings. I don't think you could pay me $1.70 to drink this again. Point goes to Starbucks, and Tim's, you're on thin ice. We're moving on to the frozen round now, and starting on my left is the Pumpkin Spice Frappuccino from Starbucks, the small retailing for $5.25. And on your right is the Pumpkin Spice Ice Cap from Tim Hortons, the small size retailing for just $3.19. The dollar difference is staggering, a little over $2, but as we learned in the last round, that doesn't mean a thing. These guys know how to frap. They've got their process down cold, literally, I guess. In all the years I've had Frappuccinos, I've been disappointed only one time. Looking squarely at you, strawberry funnel cake. Outside of that one blunder though, these are always a hit. I once let my 4-year-old take a sip of my mocha chip frap, and it's been about 3 months since then and he's still buzzing. Now that is a lot more like it, Tim's. Play to your strengths. Stepping into the lattes wasn't your world. You're not baristas. Trust me, you get my coffee order right like 30% of the time, and my order is literally just coffee with milk and Splenda. Oh yeah, so much more like it. It's creamy, it's smooth, it's got that cinnamon and nutmeg flavor with some tasty pumpkin drizzle. I think that's enough to get you back into the game, Timmy. Point goes to you. Now we're moving into the secondary beverages with a couple of the restaurant's lesser known temporary offerings. On the left is Starbucks Apple Crisp Macchiato, described as the layered flavors of apple and brown sugar meld like the fillings of a gooey apple pie in harmony with espresso, steamed milk, and caramelized spice apple drizzle. It retails for $4.95. On the right is Tim Hortons Pumpkin Spice Tea, the small retailing for $1.54, and it doesn't come with a description at all. It's how they keep their costs down. They let Starbucks keep their fancy scribes and wordsmiths, and Tim Hortons passes the savings on to you. I really like everything going on here. Apples and caramel are like that couple that everybody just sort of fawns over. Oh, they're so perfect together. I love how much apples loves caramel. Why don't you hold my hand anymore? I bet apples holds caramel's hand. I'm starting starting to understand why there's no description. If they had one, it would read, hot water poured over a flavorless tea bag. Point to Starbucks, and it's not even close. All right, we're getting down and dirty with some baked goods. And starting on the left, we have Starbucks warmed pumpkin spice scone retailing for $3.45. On the right is Tim Hortons apple pie dream donut retailing for just $1.99. Taking a look at these two baked goods, you'd have to assume this ridiculous donut is carrying an awful lot more calories, but it's actually just 263 compared to the belt busting 500 calorie total of the scone. That's a great scone. It's warm, it's got great pumpkin spice flavor, the icing is sweet and complimentary, and doesn't take away from the star of the show. Once again, Starbucks is bringing the heat. Oh man. That is so sweet and apple-y, but that's what you're looking for when you get a donut. You know, sometimes I feel bad for the old-fashioned ones you see in the store. I think they were probably originally called fashion donuts, but since nobody's ever bought one, now they're old-fashioned. Oh, I love this donut so much, and honestly, I thought Starbucks had this competition wrapped up with this scone because it is that good. In fact, I'd probably order it more often than the donut because I like the dense cakiness with my coffee. But in terms of what I'd reach for, like in a vacuum, it's the donut. Point to Tim Hortons in this round. It all comes down to the muffins. Exactly what's predicted in the New Testament. As Jesus and the disciples walked the path to Nazareth, muffins were brought to them by all the shepherds. As Jesus shared the bounty with all the people of the land, he saideth, this is where it ends. You can totally look it up if you don't believe me. On the left, we have the Starbucks pumpkin cream cheese muffin, whose description I will leave out of this round because it uses the word moist a little bit more frequently than you're probably comfortable with. It retails for $3.25. On the right is the Tim Hortons pumpkin spice muffin, which retails for $1.79. All right, I wanna make sure I get a bite with a little bit of everything in there. Oh, there's that cream cheese. All of it in one shot, but everything I've had from Starbucks today has been lights out. It's actually kind of shocking they're tied going into this last round. Like everything else I've tried today, this hits. It's warm, it's soft, the icing's real nice. This is a god tier muffin. This one's got the cream cheese icing as well. Gotta make sure I get a bit of that. Tim Hortons muffins are hit or miss. When they're on, they're on, and when they're off, they're this. The cream cheese icing is too cheesy. I want it to taste like icing, not cheese. I certainly didn't ask for a pumpkin cheese muffin. Just the idea of that description makes me want to gag, and honestly, that's what I got. Easy point to Starbucks. And with that, Starbucks, you are officially crowned the Pumpkin of the 2021 season. You guys have set the bar so high, and your competition's gonna have to work to regroup if they even want a chance to knock you off your throne during the holiday season. As always, thank you for remembering to like this video, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.